Britain is a nation of dog lovers.
I know.
But what happens when we love our dogs too much?
You're naughty, eh?
And domestic bliss descends to chaos. Luckily, there's someone you can call.
I'll take on any dog.
No!
Any size. Any problem.
Master dog trainer Graeme Hall is on a mission to restore harmony across the country.
Oi, 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 oi.
Man, that was fast.
How about?
I built my reputation on getting lasting results really quickly.
And for many, he's their last hope.
Stop it, ow!
Right, whoa, that's enough. OK, you're playing Russian roulette here. I need you to man up.
Right.
When he's biting you,
no. We
can't ignore that.
In Graham's casebook this week...
No.
Teddy and Fudge, two super-strength labradors.
No.
Too dangerous to walk.
All right.
Shaking, little man.
Stanley, a grief-stricken terrier...
Amazing.
..whose owners are struggling to cope.
I feel like that's my fault.
And Graham meets his match.
Oh, my God, Piggy!
With Piggy, a cunning escape artist.
I'm not 100% sure it's going to work. Sorry.
I don't need a new trainer.
Peg!
Over the past 10 years, Graham's travelled the country, helping owners get their dogs more disciplined.
I do things that make sense to real people. It's got to be OK to tell your dog off because they've got to understand when they've got it wrong as well as when they've got it right. From time to time, all of us need to know when we got it wrong.
Graham's first house call is to the Hevingham family in Surrey, whose lawless Labradors are out of control.
Teddy, no! Teddy!
This is Fudge. So Fudge is two, and this is her brother, Teddy. Teddy is one. Very, very much follows his sister and does all the naughty things that she encourages him to do. Come on!
They've destroyed it, like everything else.
There's no jumping.
No.
Get out!
6 years ago, owner Alana had a major back operation and was advised to keep active.
We got the dogs really to kind of encourage rehabilitation, really, to kind of go for walks and get back on my feet.
They love going for a walk. Yeah, it's the highlight of their day.
And what better way to keep mobile than walking a dog, or even two?
Wait. Oh, my God! No! But stop!
I'm sure they've got the horsepower of, like, a small car. When they want to go for something, that's it, they go.
I just end up tethering myself to something so that I can have a break. Because I can't keep going. Come on!
And these two tearaways are a big concern for the whole family.
I'm worried about my mum's back more than anything and them, like, pulling her over.
Oh! Oh, my God! He's just pulled me across the floor, so, yeah.
Alana lives in fear her labs will leave her with a serious injury.
No!
I learned to kind of expect it. Kind of... Just can never relax.
But help is on its way. And it's a problem Graham's very familiar with.
I've got a Labrador cross myself, and when she came to us, she could pull like an absolute train. So that's taken quite a bit of work to get her to walk nicely.
First, Graham wants to experience their behaviour behind closed doors.
Who's that?
Hello.
Hello.
Alana, hi. Hi. Nice to meet you. Oh, shall I come in, sorry?
Yes. Sneak through.
Right, hello, you two.
Hello.
Right, hello. Oh, hello.
No, yeah. Sorry, yeah.
Blimey, right, oh, God, yeah.
Oh, yeah, please watch your nose. Right. Yeah.
What do you normally do when this happens, then?
I try and lock them away or grab them. So, come on. Oh, right, OK. Come on.
Right. Oh, go on, in you go.
Come on.
Right.
Come on.
God, blimey.
Ah. No.
Gonna sit down. Yep.
To get to the bottom of a problem, Graeme likes to sit calmly and discuss it with the owner.
Well, oh, blimey.
Just sit down, Teddy.
Oi.
Teddy.
Teddy.
But with these two ignoring Alana's attempts to control them...
Teddy.
That's easier said than done.
Teddy.
But this is quite normal, is it?
Yeah. Teddy likes to be in your face and he likes to come and say hello.
Yeah.
Teddy, you gonna sit down?
So I knew that there was a problem with walking, but I didn't know those dogs. They have no idea of what the rules and boundaries are in that house. What are the rules in your house when it comes to the dogs?
Well, they're not allowed upstairs.
Right.
They're allowed to sit on the sofa.
Right.
They'll kind of sit and wait patiently for food.
Okay. That's the one thing we've got.
Yeah, I know. It kind of feels like I'm clutching at straws, really.
I know. Yeah. These are lovely dogs, but they've got no manners.
Hello.
Coming up, will a bit of domestic decorum inside be the key to calm walks outside?
He's just running.
This is an out of control situation.
And Graeme faces doubt.
Oh my God, Peggy!
From the owners of a four-legged runaway.
I don't think he's a trainer.
Master dog trainer Graeme Hall tackles some of Britain's unruliest dogs. Today he's helping Alana Hevingham, who's risking serious injury every time she walks her dogs. First, he wants Alana to gain control in the home.
Blimey, right, blimey.
And he has a plan to stop this pair of leery labs treating guests like doormats.
There's a little secret to know, which is dogs hate to be off balance. So if we nudge them off balance, and we're not talking about anything brutal, we're putting in this isn't what I wanted sort of feeling.
Once they're off balance, the dogs need a clear command and praise when they're grounded.
At the same time, we're saying a new command, which is just off, simple as that. And the face that goes with it, of course, is that, I wouldn't if I were you.
Okay.
But while those paws are on the ground, we can get to praise them.
Okay.
So from at no off, you know, we go to, oh, good, that's very nice, right?
Graeme shows Alana how it's done.
Come on, you two. Hello. Hello. Ah, no. Ah. Hello. Off. Good boy. That's very... Ah, off. Good. Ah. Good boy. Oh, that's very good. Now, he's learned that quite quickly.
With a clear command and a nudge, it's taken Graeme just minutes to bring this delinquent duo into line.
So they're not calm, but they've got the paws on the ground. Oh, good girl.
Now Alana's been shown the way, it's her turn to take control. And the kids returning home allow her to put Graham's training to the test.
Hello, I'm Graeme. Nice to meet you.
Hello.
Hiya, you all right? We put the dogs in the conservatory for the minute. Should we let them in?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I think we'd rather should we? Come on, you two, the kids are home.
Hello.
But can Alana show this disobedient pair who's in charge?
Oh, well done.
Yeah.
Off.
Well done.
Off.
Good. That's very good. So how was that compared to normal?
I think they both did really well. I've never seen them that calm before, to be honest.
Yeah, that's really good, isn't it?
With clear commands and plenty of praise, Teddy and Fudge now know there's a new boss in town.
What we need to fix next, of course, is the walking.
Oh, God.
Knowing Alana's frightened of getting injured, Graham's got it covered.
OK, so if I click that on like that, you see, then as we're walking, if need be, I can put the lock in.
OK.
And I've got you.
I do feel really anxious about it, but I understand that we have to show Graeme the behaviour, but it's still stressful. Yes, I can't. He's just running.
This is what you do, you just run. This is an out of control situation where two dogs are taking a lady for a drag. You look like the water skiers.
Oh,
there we go. Oh, we're off. This is a ticking time bomb because if Alana's pulled over in the wrong direction, that's going to lead to a serious injury. Blimey, look at him go. You want me to take over?
Yeah.
Oh, that's enough.
Realising this isn't a problem he can fix in a day, Graeme wants Alana to spend some time working on her confidence and control indoors, whilst he comes up with a plan.
Thank you so much. Thanks.
You're welcome. Bye. See ya. The stakes are very high, so I need to really think about how I frame this training, how I do it, so that we don't in any way put her in danger.
It's a new day, and Graeme's off to Cambridgeshire to see a dog he's been told is untrainable. Escape artist Peggy.
Oh my God, Peggy! No!
Peggy's constantly giving owner Sarah and daughter Jodie the runaround.
Do you left the window open?
Blame me, it's your dog.
Peggy, Peggy!
Come on, this way!
The more they call her back...
Peggy, this way!
...the faster she runs.
Anything she can jump up and get her paws over, she can scramble over. I've never seen anything like it.
Peggy, Peggy!
Come
on, this way!
Oh, she's gone!
And once she's gone, you just can't catch her.
Where is she? I can't see her.
I don't know, Mum.
At that point, you either have to wait for her to come back 3 or 4 hours later, or wait for someone to pick her up and ring you.
Peg!
If Peg's not enjoying the great outdoors, she's making house calls.
What are you doing? Hey?
She frightens my little cat to death.
No.
She's an absolute minx.
That's what she is.
She thinks everybody is her friend.
I spend my time apologising and thank you for bringing her back and thank you for calling me.
It's a pleasure when she comes round, but it's a pleasure when she goes.
I make a point of telling people she's not my dog, she's my mum's dog.
On or off the lead, Peggy has one thing on her mind.
Peggy, come back this way, that's naughty.
She just wants to hunt.
Peggy, out of
Get
there.
Get out of there!
She likes to explore holes.
I would love to be able to let her off the lead.
Peggy, wait.
Once she sniffs out her prey, she's unstoppable.
Literally, like you can see how I'm literally having to hold myself. Peggy, come here. Let's see, this is what she's like if she gets on the scent. No, come here. No. And I'd love her to be able to come when she's called. Peggy. Peggy, right, no, wait.
This is absolutely mission impossible to train this dog.
Some dogs just do want to bolt out the home. It's really difficult with terriers to get them to recall to come back to you successfully. The biggest worry when a dog runs off is being knocked over by cars. It's a miracle, frankly, that Peggy's not hurt herself yet.
To stop Peggy bolting, Graeme needs to know more about what triggers it.
Hello. Hi, okay. This is Peggy.
I can't look out of the
Sarah, nice to meet you. Hello. Yeah. So, what do we think's in the mix with Peggy?
Her dad was just a little terrier. Her mother was a cross between an Airedale and a retriever.
Does she do much retrieving?
No.
No. She does a lot of what terriers do, then,
yes.
Does she?
Her scent drive is so strong.
Right.
And she just goes.
And when she does bolt, you can't get her back.
Exactly. So it is the recall.
How long is she away for?
Anywhere between 2 and 4 hours.
Are you winding me up? When you've been away, she's been gone 8 hours before.
Has she?
Yeah.
Where's she go for 8 hours?
Up the woods. My worst fear is just losing her totally, really.
Well, I need to see the problem. So I've got something in my bag, which is about 20 metres worth of long line. What I want to do is just put this on her so that she can't really escape. And then I want you to just like open the door and let's just see what this is like. And then do your best to get her back.
The long line technique means Peggy should feel free to roam.
I'm sitting out here just waiting for Sarah to open the door. And there are two things I'm looking for. One is the dog behaviour, but more importantly, I want to see what Sarah does to try and get her back.
Come on, Peggy.
Come here, back in.
Come on, this way. Come on, Peggy, you come. Good girl, come on. Come on, in. Come on, Peggy. Come on, good girl. Come on, Peggy.
Come on.
No, Peggy.
She's not listening at all to Mum. And off they go now, down the lane.
Oh,
she's gone.
She's gone.
Peggy! Come on!
Come, Peggy, this way. Come on. Come on, walkies. Come on.
Well, as you can hear, it's Peggy this way. Come on, all the rest of it. And clearly not listening. So how long does this normally last for?
Hours.
in the middle of a bramble patch.
As Graeme works out why Peggy's not responding...
Peggy, come on, good girl!
It seems Jodie's read his mind.
How is that a good girl? She's going in, brambles, stinging herself, going, there's a good girl. Yeah, there's nothing good about that. She's taking the mick out of her.
She is, yeah.
Well, Sarah and Jodie both clearly got their own ideas about how to do things. But here's the thing, neither of them can control that dog. You got her?
I clipped her.
After a tangle in the brambles, it's time for some home truths.
Well, that was a disaster. There's something you said to me, and it was about your mum saying, good girl.
Peggy will be doing something naughty, and because you want to get close to her, you're like, oh, there's a good girl.
Fair comment?
Yeah, I guess so. Maybe I don't realise I'm doing it.
You miss timing the good girl. So quite often when she's being naughty at a given point, the dog just goes, oh, good girl. Trouble is, it's not funny though, is it? Because one day, if you're not careful, Peggy might not come back.
We just got told off, I think. It was really hard not to laugh. Do you know what it's like being in front of the headmaster?
You need a system to work to. We need a system for walking out the door, and we need a system for getting her back. And you practice them, you'll see an improvement.
I totally understand where you're coming from. Totally get it. But I'm not 100% sure it's going to work. Sorry.
No, that's OK. Yeah, yeah.
I don't think you can train her.
I'm feeling the pressure here because if I can't show them some improvement today, I'll walk back down that drive and they'll be thinking, well, that was a waste of time.
Graeme wants to begin by tackling Peggy's recall.
Peggy! Come on! Come, Peggy, this way, come on!
Starting by simplifying what they say to get her back.
So, first of all, we need a command, don't we? So, what would you say?
What, to Peggy?
Yeah.
Peggy here.
You need to stick to that. Because if it starts being, come here, Peggy, Peggy, come here, wait, oi, will you, you know, you did this yesterday, it's just not going to work.
Yeah.
But in Peggy's case, a command might not be enough.
Habits are funny things, and whether you're a dog or a human, it's the same. They come from practicing something again and again and again.
To get Peggy into the habit of returning, Graham's using a 20-metre training line.
Come on, you. Let's encourage her to mooch about.
With a command...
Peggy! Here!
Followed by a flick of the line...
Oh, good girl! What's this?
She's recalled.
There you go!
Once she's returned, she gets her favourite treat, a sausage. Every time Peggy runs to Graeme...
Peggy, here!
He reels the line in and runs back, turning it into a fun game.
Super! Where I want them to get to is that one day, automatically, and without the long line, when they call her back, she just comes. There's your dog. Right, off you go, let's put it all together.
Peggy here? Clever girl! Come on!
Peggy seems to be responding, but there's a hitch.
Come on, here, Peggy, here.
Now you're in a mess. Sarah got a bit flustered. She forgot to bring the line back in. All you're going to do is strip it back in big, long lead lengths behind you and just throw it behind you as you go.
Peggy here? Peggy here.
Oh,
clever
super.
Girl! Clever girl!
A dog that once ignored her owners is now happy to come back.
And you brought your lead back, well done.
And with each attempt, Peggy's obedience grows.
Peggy, here.
Oh, well done.
Girl.
I'm surprised, that's good.
The fact that she's acknowledging me and came bounding back towards me, that is a result in itself.
Sarah looked over the moon the first time she called Peggy and she came straight back, because there's that instant recognition. It's like, oh, my dog does want to run to me.
I'm quite shocked, really. I think I owe a bit of an apology for doubting him so much.
He kind of got instant results.
It is a bit annoying.
It is a bit annoying.
Obviously, we want it to be a success, but it's sort of like, are you winding me up?
I hope she's just not lulling us into a false sense of security.
With Peggy's recall training in place, Graeme can turn his attention to her escaping antics.
Peggy, come on, this way! Oh, she's gone!
By creating an uncrossable boundary, in this case, a doormat.
When I open the door, if she goes to move, I'm going to use a bit of body language to block and get her to move backwards. This is the no-go area for the dog. We're going to start not with the door fully open, we're going to make it a bit easier and just have it just a crack open. If she goes forward towards the door, she gets in trouble. When she moves back, off the doormat, she gets praise. So, what's that then? Ah, no. Now, she didn't cross the line there, but she was about to. So I had to be quick and block. cover it. Good girl. What do you reckon? Good girl, that's super. If I walk out, what would happen? Ah, no. Good girl. Super. Notice I'm not saying stay and holding my hand and walking backwards.
Just going,
it's really clear, really simple. Clever girl. Good. Clever girl. That's super.
Impressed.
Yeah, that's pretty impressive, Graeme.
But will this little bolter stay put when Sarah tries?
Do your worst.
Ah, wait.
Right, so just hold it at that. Good girl, exactly. So you need to go around the other side. That's it, get ready and watch her. That's it. Be ready to step in if you have to. You can tell a good girl, because at the moment this is good
girl. That is really good girl. That's clever
it.
Girl.
Now take a step out the door.
Good girl.
That's it.
Wait.
That's it.
Clever girl.
Take a step back again. Yeah, this is really good. Keep going. Keep an eye on her though. Good girl. And then
good
without
girl.
Rushing. Right, shut the door. Super. How did that feel?
Yeah, that was really good.
Escape artist Peggy now knows her boundaries.
We've come a long way in a day.
Yeah, definitely.
Just remember, if you think it's going to work, you've got half a chance. If you think it's all going to come crashing down, you'll pretty much make that happen.
You said this morning she's untrainable. All my neighbours have said she's untrainable. My dad said she's untrainable.
Right.
So you've come along and you've actually said at the end of the day, this dog is trainable, and I think she's trainable.
You've just got to put the training in.
With Graeme's training regime in place.
Cheers.
It's now up to Sarah and Jodie.
Hey, you up for the challenge, Peggy? You up for the challenge?
Coming up, an anxious terrier.
Shaking little man.
Grieving for his doggy companion.
Maybe if he'd seen her, I might have helped. Why should it come up?
For over 10 years, master dog trainer Graeme Hall's tackled all sorts of problems. Whilst many of the dogs he treats are unruly and disobedient, his next case is helping a bereaved pet, a subject close to home.
I'm just looking at a few pictures of Axel and Gordon, my two Rotties, bless them. They've passed on now, you know, but this one's a sad one, really, because it's the last picture I've got of Gordon. We didn't know it at the time, but he was quite ill, bless him. But it's nice to be able to help other dogs that are going through, well, really what Gordon went through when we lost Axel. I think to some extent, for the sake of the other dog, you've kind of got to do business as usual. And if you can be as normal as possible, I'm convinced it speeds things up.
In Blackpool, grieving Cairn Terrier Stanley is suffering from panic attacks.
Hello. Come in.
It's all right.
Just please excuse the dog. Just be careful. Get in, boy. Get in. Good boy.
Stanley, it's okay. Stanley, come on.
Leave him. He'll come down in a minute. He always barks like this. All right. Come
on,
this way.
It's all right. It's all right, Stanley.
Come here.
Okay. Sorry about that.
This is Stanley. We've had him for about 4.5 years. If someone comes in, it could be 10, 15 minutes before he'll stop.
It's all right. It's okay, isn't it?
His little heart's going 10 to the dozen. He suffers from stress. He doesn't enjoy himself the way he used to.
When the Wilkinsons first got Stanley, he was a totally different dog.
Our Westie at the time, Sweep, took him under her wing, and they were inseparable.
Everything was great. They loved each other. It was all going well. And then, sadly, Sweep got a short illness last year. Unfortunately, she didn't make it.
Since then, he's not the same dog. He's lost his leader, and he doesn't seem to be able to cope anymore.
Since losing Sweep, the slightest thing terrifies this little terrier.
He can be set off by a noise miles away that we can't hear. Noises in the garden.
You can close a cupboard in the kitchen. And he'll bark in the front room because he's heard a bang.
Stanley.
Without his best friend by his side...
Stanley!
Poor Stanley can't cope with the outside world.
So when we're out and we're coming into, like, a busy area, you can sense the change in him. Stanley, come on, good boy, he's OK. He just panics, he doesn't know what to do. Come on, let's go. Come on. It's as though he just can't cope in certain situations. because he always looked to Sweep, and he'd see Sweep calm and think, well, this is OK.
Pick him up.
Come on. It's all right. He struggles that much, and then you end up getting stressed, and then Lily normally gets upset when he gets really stressed. It's all right, don't cry. We're going the zebra crossing, yeah? In the end, you just think, well, this isn't a fun family day out, so we might as well go.
With little Stan in fear as soon as he leaves home, family holidays are a write-off.
Stanley, we don't get much fun stuff and, like, family time together because of how stressed he is.
Go get it! I go on holiday with my daughter on my own, separately.
That's the best solution. They go on holiday, I stay here with him, and everyone's a winner.
With their terrified terrier showing no signs of getting over his loss, they're desperate for Graeme's help.
The first thing I want to understand today is whether or not Susan and Lee are doing the right things, because as humans, we can absolutely make this a bit better, or indeed, a bit worse.
The family feel the way they handle Sweep's death is a big part of the problem.
We put Stanley outside when we took her to the vets. And Lee said, just let him see Sweet. And I said, no, she's going to be all right. And unfortunately, Sweet didn't come back from the vets. He couldn't understand why she'd gone. She'd just not come back.
So I feel like that's my fault. Because maybe if he'd seen her, then he could have picked up something. And that might have helped. Why
should it come back? Graeme, good morning.
Yes, really.
Yeah, hi, pleased to meet you. Hello,
nice
there.
To meet you.
Come in, please.
Thank you very much. Where's the patient?
Okay, so this is Stanley.
Come on, boy.
Come on,
in you come.
It's okay.
No, come on. In. Good boy.
There
you go.
All right, then. Tell you what, let me grab a scissors.
Okay.
And we'll have a chat. So, oh dear, he's on edge, isn't he? So yeah. How long has he been like this then?
12 months, really, since we lost our Westie Sweep.
Yeah, effectively, yeah. He's lost his surrogate mum. It would be one way of putting it, you know.
Who's he looking up to now then?
I'd like to say us. We try our best.
In order to help Stanley, Graeme wants to see just how badly he misses Sweep.
What's this then?
This is Sweep.
Stanley, who's that? Who is it? Oh, look. You know, he knows. And then he went and he had a little sniff and went, it's not the real thing. Bless him. He really does miss her, doesn't he?
Yeah.
How does that make you feel, seeing that?
Hard. It kind of prolongs it, in a sense, because he's not coping.
So you can't move on, because he can't move on.
Yeah.
My heart goes out to him, because if we weren't to fix it, I think the evidence is there that, you know, it could get worse. And I don't want that to continue.
Lovely.
The first step to fixing it is seeing how Stanley copes when he's outside.
Right, I've brought you down the prom because I want to see what he's like in public. And I'll be honest, I want to see how you're reacting as well. So it's just really important for me that you just do your normal thing.
Okay.
All right?
Okay. Come on. Stanley, come on.
Come on, boy. Come on. Let's pick him up a little bit.
Pick him up, then. Come on. He might be all right here. He's
Try
got around
now.
The corner.
Come on.
Right, come on.
As we're getting nearer to people, he's beginning to get more anxious, bless him.
It's OK. It's OK. Stanley, it's OK. Stanley, come on. Stanley, come on, it's OK.
He's scared, bless him, and he's panicking. So he's going backwards, he's looking panicky, they're looking panicky, and nothing about that situation is going to reassure him.
It's OK, Stanley, it's OK.
See, as soon as you stop, though...
It's OK. Stanley, it's OK.
Come on.
But Graeme spotted the family's attempts to calm little Stan.
Come on, it's OK. Yeah. See? It's fine.
..are having the opposite effect.
Every time he's barking and he's looking anxious and they're saying, it's all right, in effect, they're saying, it's all right to be anxious like this.
It's all right.
Come on.
It's all right. See, come on, we're moving.
And Graham's keeping a secret count.
It's all right. Stanley, come on. Come on, sweetheart. It's OK.
Just going to wonder what it's doing to his little heart as well, though, because he's clearly distressed, you know.
Come on.
You okay?
Oh, little boy.
It's okay. Okay.
Shaking, little man.
They're doing quite a lot of things wrong. That sounds like bad news, but to me it's good news because if I've seen things that are wrong, I can fix it. Essentially, what's happening is he is feeling that grief, you know, and his way of expressing that is by getting anxious, bless him.
Yeah.
And you don't know how to cope with it. Actually, you're making it worse. Every time he gets particularly bad, you're trying to calm him down. So you're saying, all right, it's all right, right? Okay, good boy sometimes, and come on in a nice voice. Now, unbeknownst to you, I was counting the number of times on a little counter.
42.
42 times. In effect, you rewarded him for being anxious.
I'm surprised it's 42,
You do it without thinking.
Graeme's solution is devastatingly simple.
When he cries and he whimpers and he's scared, I am asking you to ignore that. You need to do nothing. And don't pick him up, because a lot of the time you pick him up and give him a cuddle just at its worst.
Yeah.
So you're not allowed to do that anymore.
Right.
How's that feel?
Hard.
Yeah.
Very hard.
Can you do it?
Yeah, if it makes him better, I can do anything.
You're going to have to. It's not going to be easy. It's very difficult to ignore your baby when he's crying.
Graeme wants to show Susan and Lee how it's done, but will his technique keep Stanley's panic attacks at bay?
Come on, young man. Stanley. Boy, that's better. What's going on in the shopping centre then? Not a lot. Ah, good lad.
By praising him and leading the way,
No.
Stanley walks calmly.
You're not even looking for us. Stanley, your mum and dad are here. You're not bothered.
No.
Come on then. Yeah, good boy.
So, definitely us then.
Very good. Well, how's that compared to normal?
Totally different. Normally, he's like, no, don't take me away from mum and dad. And he was like, just off into the distance.
See you, mum.
Yeah.
Wouldn't want to be
here. Better than you.
There's something else. I'm walking along the street looking like I'm the king of Blackpool, really. Just calm, all's well with the world. And it's rubbing off on him, because he's starting to go, oh, well, if you think it's all right, it's all right. Just like he did with Sweet. What Susan and Lee need to do is to remember not to tense up and start to lose your posture. They'll need to think, this is okay, I can deal with this, even if they're not quite sure. I've had an idea. I'm going to get you to do this without the dog. I want you to walk from here towards the winter gardens and back again in the manner of the Queen of Blackpool. Elegant and tall and I know what I'm doing, all's well with the world.
See you later then.
See ya, Queen of Blackpool.
Okay.
Well, that's all right, isn't it?
Yeah.
She can do it without a dog. She looks like a model on the catwalk walking towards us now.
We haven't got that far. She looks good, yeah, she looks good.
Marvellous, yes. Yeah. Yes, thank you so much, yes. You can see the point I'm making.
Yeah.
That's the picture you need to be sending out as you're walking around. So we convince him that actually he's with somebody who knows what they're doing. He's your little loyal subject.
With Susan finding her confidence, will Stanley follow in her footsteps?
I know it's not going to be easy. I've just got to keep myself in check now to remember to stay calm and show I'm in control.
On you go.
She's not focusing on him, is she? She's just focusing on what
she's doing. What she's doing now is going, I'm going that way, young man. You're with me.
With Susan remaining calm and confident.
Oh, Stanley, you've been such a good boy.
Her once panicked pooch is totally chilled.
I do feel confident. I was just making sure about the dog there, but he's not barked. And I just can't believe it.
Hey, this is great.
You've been a good boy.
Right, come back to me here then.
I was channeling the inner queen.
Oh, there you go.
I felt in control, strangely enough.
Did he pull at all?
He did a little bit. I felt myself starting to go a bit because I clocked a dog.
Yes.
So I clocked the dog and I thought, no,
yeah.
Keep calm. And he didn't bark. Him not being in a mad state of panic and barking and creating is unbelievable.
And the more you practice this stuff, the more he'll just get it. The world's changed. These two know what they're doing. I'll stay with them and that's fine. And then we'll get him over it.
It's now for us to put that into practice, which we will. I'll remember my inner queen.
We've all lost people and we've lost dogs, and it is very upsetting. But you know, for those of us who are left behind, life does move on. And today I've been able to help some lovely people and a lovely little dog to do just that. Does he still miss Sweep? Yeah, of course he does. But has he got somebody else to look up to now? Absolutely. Thank Good you. Luck to you.
Thank you very much.
Put it there.
Can I hug you?
Well done, of course you can. Well done, darling. You did really well.
Thank you.
Lee, it's a pleasure. Bye-bye, Stanley. Have a nice life.
You've been a good boy today.
You've been a superstar, Stanley.
Coming up, Graeme has unfinished business with Teddy and Fudge.
Oh, God!
Having transformed their behaviour indoors...
Oh. Well done.
..he wants to tackle their dangerous behaviour outdoors.
Oh, no, no, no!
Graeme's back in Surrey to finish his toughest challenge of the week. Helping Alana, who has a chronic back problem, walk Teddy and Fudge safely. Any more falls could leave her permanently injured.
You just can never relax.
I've had a fairly sleepless night because I've been thinking about how I'm going to work this. Two things. I mustn't do anything that means she's likely to fall over, but also she's quite anxious, understandably, and I don't want to push her out of her comfort zone. Yeah, I mean, let's make no mistake, this ain't easy.
On his last visit, Graeme taught Alana how to bring her dastardly duo into line.
Oh. Well done.
Graeme's keen to see if she's managed to keep control.
You're gonna be good, you're gonna sit. Hi.
Hello again, you're all right.
Welcome, hi, come on in.
Hi. Thank you, hello you
hello.
Two. Remember me? Oh, well done.
Off!
That's it. Good. Hey, that's better. Well, I'm glad they're pleased to see me. She's still jumping a bit, and he didn't jump at all.
Yeah, it feels like they're listening to me. So it feels actually like now, if I want them to do certain things, I feel like I can actually get the results. Yeah, it's definitely given me more confidence.
The big test, of course, is today, so we need to get out and teach them to walk nicely so that you can do it.
I'm nervous because I don't really know how to manage both of the dogs, so excited and nervous at the same time.
Graeme starts with a tip which could drastically reduce Teddy and Fudge's pulling power.
Come on, come on.
By ditching the harnesses Alana's been using to walk them.
Harnesses can be useful for some dogs, but I think in your case it's part of the problem because, in effect, it just harnesses the power so they can kind of lean forward, breathe very nicely, thank you much, thank you very much, and off we go. But you will have a lot more control with a collar. We moved from a harness to a collar because it gave us a bit more control and the dog's less ability to pull.
No.
Oh, well done.
Graeme wants Alana to adapt the training she used indoors, where a nudge and a clear command helped her gain control. Outdoors, the nudge will be replaced with a lead technique.
I'll send a little flick down through the collar, you know? But I'm also going to use my voice to tell him when he's got it wrong. It's as simple as saying no, if necessary. However, if he's walking nicely in the right place, I'll be praising him.
With Alana low on confidence, Graeme wants to get her to walk one dog properly and to show her how, he's going to demonstrate with Teddy.
Right, off we go. Come on, you. Good boy. Wait, come on. Never mind Fudge, you're with me.
The moment Teddy shows the slightest hint of not following Graham's lead, he's put back on track.
Come on. Good boy. Now, that correction was the lightest of flicks there. All I'm doing is really using my thumb and a forefinger just to go, oi.
He looks so subservient, like...
If I stop, he's stopping. And if I move, he moves. Good boy.
When Teddy has another turn...
Yeah! Shall we go a bit quicker?
This lab that once dictated the pace gives Graeme complete control.
It's ridiculous. He's just running with him. It's just ridiculous.
With Teddy transformed, Graeme wants to see if Alana can handle Fudge.
What Alana needs to do is she needs to stay relaxed, because if she's not relaxed, the dog won't be. So every time you've got the dogs on lead and you're ready to go, just check, you know? What am I like? Oh, yeah, I need to relax a bit. And my arm's dangling. Then you can walk.
When it came to my turn, I really was nervous because I'm constantly thinking, is something going to come? Are they going to take me by surprise? No. Good girl, Fudgy. No. No.
Oh, now it's all gone horribly wrong. Fudge pulled across to one side. There's obviously an interesting smell in the verge just there. And it was just like 2 or 3 seconds, really, before she did anything. And then finally, she got back on track.
But as the walk goes on...
No. Good girl, Fudgy.
Alana's confidence and control improves.
That was really good. There was one bit she pulled across to the grass verge.
Yeah.
But it was, 2-3 seconds before you reacted.
Yeah. I can tell that she's a little bit more hesitant to do what I want her to, but she's definitely responded.
The message really is, I'll tell you when it's time to have a sniff and a wee and all of those things that dogs do. But if I'm walking, I'm walking. Yeah. Well, I wasn't sure how that was going to go because Alana wasn't at all confident this morning, but you know, that was good. She was calm and controlled, so I think it's time to up the ante. Right, second dog. There you go. So, that's it.
Okay.
So when you're ready, yes, just walk through him and off we go. Right, okay. Over to you.
No.
That's it. Well done.
No. Teddy's amazing. He's picked it up straight away. Fudge still needs a little bit of reminding. No. No.
Alana, she's struggling to do it right sometimes because it's all new to her and she's a bit nervous still, of course.
No.
But she's determined now and that counts for a lot.
No. Good girl.
Only days ago, it was Teddy and Fudge setting the pace.
Wait.
Dragging Alana all around town.
And the difference is that now it's Mum who's going where she wants and the speed she wants. Happier?
Yeah. It feels amazing, really. I don't think I can remember a time where I've been able to just walk them without any problems at all.
After I've gone, you probably shouldn't go straight to walking the two dogs together. I think, yes, he's going to be a piece of cake.
Yeah.
And she's quite determined.
Yeah.
But you're a more determined lady than she is a dog.
I'll definitely listen to what Graeme said and I'll take it one at a time and start trying to build my confidence with them. I'm really excited to take them out, to show the kids, and then to say, well, we can all do this together as a family.
In Blackpool, anxious Stanley still misses Sweep, but his panic attacks are a thing of the past.
It's like having a different dog to what we had before.
Now we can go on, like, trips to the lakes and we can go on holiday.
Good boy.
In Cambridgeshire, runaway Peggy's obedience is getting better by the day.
Clever girl.
And in Surrey, Teddy and Fudge are showing real signs of improvement and Alana's confidence continues to grow.
Fudgy, good girl. Good girl.
Next time, Bella, an aggressive collie terrorising the neighbourhood.
Without that muzzle, I'd have been bitten about 4 times, eh?
No, 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 no.
Toby,
down.
A basset hound that does what he wants, when he wants.
Toby, please don't poo in their garden.
And Dave, an affectionate bulldog
oh, no.
with a very dirty habit.